New pastor at the church across the street, the First United Methodist Church. He's been there about 6 months. He came from Wichita Falls, but before that he was 14 years at Mount Vernon. He's also been at the church, a church in Bales and one in Sherman. And I think that makes him kind of a local guy already. We're going to call him one of our own. And he and his wife Jackie have two sons, and I think they're both grown. One's married, and one I think is going to pursue a career in the military. And we're just delighted to have them here, and I think you're going to enjoy Parson Bob this evening. So let me hear you give it up for Parson Bob.
Thank you. I was going to read a bunch of stuff to you, but I can't see anything above the light out there. I can't even see you. So I'm trusting that you're still out there, right? We have a lot of neat stuff going on tonight. We have lots of entertainment, so we want to get right to it. I just want to tell you that I retired after 4.5 years from the Oklahoma National Guard. And I don't know whether that's good or bad, but that's where I was for a long time. And they sent my battalion to overseas without even telling me that. And I can only assume that they have a younger and better looking chaplain that went with them, and they didn't want me to go because I'll soon be 60 years old and probably won't be anymore. But we're glad to be in Bonham. We're glad to be here. You've already welcomed us greatly. I know the Bonham girls softball team with our softball team from Mount Vernon, where I'm from, the purple warriors with the purple tigers. And I really didn't know what to do except say go purple. I didn't really know how to do that. But anyway, I'm glad y'all gave us that introduction and welcome into the community. We have tonight with us for the first time, on our list, is the 14th Street Reunion. And they've had a reunion. Gary was packing a guitar and boy, the banjo. And you've heard about the dueling banjo and guitar thing. Well, I guess that's what happened. And they decided that this might work. But they had to add somebody to them, and that's Lenora. And she came along to add the little oomph and boom from the bass and keep them straight. And so we're looking forward to hearing what they have for us. And it has to do with country gospel music with a bluegrass touch, sort of like hee-haw comedy, the 14th Street Reunion Band. Would you give it up for them? Thank you.
Make a final angel prayer to each of them, and they handled it, and that's it. I'm going to do one that's one of my old favorites. My grandfather worked on watches and clocks. Anyway, this is an old favorite you might remember. It's called Grandfather's Clock.
This next song that we're going to do is one that I wrote for my mother right before she died. And we put this on a record, and I'd like to do it for you right now. It's called Endless Search. The sea is to the shore as beginning. One without the other, like a breeze, without the wind. But I'll grow used to losing you, because time heals all the hurt, but the final
adopting it in 1 week.
Thank you.
So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. Yes, I will on a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. But
they never know what I'm going to do. I think that's the other way around most of the time. But when we get on stage, they never know what I'm going to do. All right. Christian than anything I know. There's a always introduced us as his neighbors. And I guess that was all that was important. Because he wouldn't introduce anybody by name, but he'd say, "This here's my neighbors." And that's how we got our name. And we're thankful to be able to have the girls grow up around those sets of grandparents. Family is a wonderful thing. It is a gift of God. I grew up as my grandpa's neighbor, and I appreciate him and the heritage that he gave us. My name is Carol Neal, and these are all my daughters. I do have a son, but he don't like to sing anywhere except in his pickup with the windows rolled up. Every once in a while we get to hear him, and we think he sounds pretty good, but he's not going to let anybody else hear him. A little bit shy like his daddy. My oldest daughter is Elizabeth. She is 24. And then Abigail is 19 on the base. She will be in a few days. Lydia is next, and she is 17 now, and she's on the guitar, and she does a lot of dancing. And Joanna is 14 on the mandolin. Susanna is 9, and she's learning the auto harp. Deborah is 7, and she's learning to play a bluegrass fiddle. She waited a long time to stand by the mic stand to sing. And she's going to sing a song that is her, what she calls her mailman song. This is dedicated to all the Christian mailmen, or women. It's called A Wicker Rocking Chair.
Thank you. But they brought with them cattle. They brought with them horses. The horses that they brought became the Mustangs. That's so important to the cattle drivers in the late 1800s. But what if those Spaniards had brought with them leghorns instead of longhorns? The cavalry took up ranching back in 1965. Didn't have much money, so no cattle could he buy. He called up his first cousin and asked him what to do. His cousin said, buy chickens. Granville chicken coon. Now he's been a rancher since he was 44. Working for the colonel for 20 years and more. Killing all those chickens and sending them to fry. Now they want revenge. Those chickens in the sky. Chickie-eye. Sound as he went along his way. When all at once a rotten egg it hit him in the eye. It was a dreadful sight. Ghost chickens in the sky. Chickie-eye. Black and shiny, and their eyes were fiery red. They had no feet or feathers, all those chickens, they were dead. They pecked him on that rancher, he died by the claw. They served him extra crispy with biscuits and coleslaw. Chickie-eye. And I figured I was tough enough to weather any storm, because I knew that I could rope and ride and wrangle with the rest. And when I put on my hat and boots, I knew I looked the best. I used to saunter into town, you know, acting sort of mean, down three fingers of popcorn and watch my heroes on the screen. Now, they were short of cowboys and brave as they could be. And they never made no mistakes, as far as I could see. My life was plumb delightful. I didn't give a hoot. But then I spied a pretty girl wearing cowboy boots. My brain began to spin. My wits was in a wad. I'd never seen no pretty girl who was manly shod. I only trailed the cowboys, but you know from where I stood, she was purely handsome. She smelled pretty good. She had some other attributes, but I just had to know, was she a real cowgirl or just putting on a show? She asked me out to her place. I was on my P's and Q's. I'd play along with her game. There was not a thing to lose. And when she asked me if I'd mind helping her clean out a stall, I said, sure enough, ma'am, I'd be glad to, because I'm a cowboy after all. Well, the barn was hot and smelly, and the manure high as I could see. And sadly, when we'd finished, she'd haul more than me. But she was pretty nice, you know, and didn't call my hand. And even then, that last smell good and look to beat the band. She told me about a fishing hole out past the vacant store where she'd caught a big one yesterday and figured there was more. We saddled up some livestock and took off in a trot, and I was riding high when we crossed that draw, and that's when I fell off. Well, she didn't laugh or giggle or insult my riding style. She just helped me get untangled and flashed a gentle smile and said that horse was just pure mean. He gave me quite a jar, and don't worry about grabbing that saddle horn. I'm sure that's what it's for. But then, things begin to get better, because I sort of liked her curls. I figured it was sure okay for a cowboy to be a girl. I left the place at sunset, and I was purely glad I came, and truth be told, since that day, my life ain't been the same. I partnered with some top hands who could sure enough stand the heat, but none of them ever looked as good or smelled quite as sweet. That gal was a sure enough puncher. And you'd agree, of course, if you'd ever seen a girl like that who could sure enough sit a horse. I'm glad I learned that lesson as young as I was then, because it saved me from that awful fate of thinking cowboys was all men. I since been down a lot of trails with females, most terrific. And I'm here to say, as I live and breathe, cowboy ain't gender specific.
Will be till I die.
of mine who ranches up in Idaho.
See you.
to say it's wonderful to be here with you this night for such an awesome cause. I'm so happy that I was able to make it. I'm truly blessed to be here with you.
Crucified.
center was. He said it was the Family Life Center.
Riegelman, and he's going to play for us and sing. I'm going to ask Mario Marcus and the Mojo Blues Band to come up. They're going to, as I understand, they're going to back him up. I'm going to tell you about Mario and Mojo in just a minute, and then they're just going to take it after he gets through. They serve to promote blues music as an original American art form and an important cultural element in American music, including gospel, country, and modern pop. So we've gone from banjo picking and ukulele picking, and mountain music, and now we've got blues. And Alex is only 17 years old, but yet he plays blues. Welcome, Alex Riegelman.
Thank you. She said she don't see no reason why the children don't be around.
Yeah. That was a good time. So glad that I was staying. Everybody was having such a good time, man. There was a song came up about, really sad song. About playing over time limits or whatever, you know? And we were all about just like, man, we're having a good time. We're having a good time watching, man. So, it's been a really good thing here. We appreciate y'all being here and letting us come up. It's called Hard Times.
Thank you.
little slow blues tune for you. This is actually by Johnny Lewis. It's called Trouble. Like he's in trouble with the feedback. Or... Sorry. What if I move? Okay.
Thank you. I've been at it since I was 11. So where are you going from here?